Hey guys, Vikas over here and this is We Are Genius. Guys, today I am with a new tutorial around Arduino. We'll see how to interface MCP328 with Arduino. MCP328 is a 8 channel 12 bit SPI based A to B converter. So if you are working on projects which requires many analog input, then on your Arduino stock pin you can go for this. The advantages of this is it provides a 12 bit resolution, 8 input channel SPI interface, 100 kilo sample per second sampling rate, and many more. I personally use this with Raspberry Pi to read analog inputs, as the Pi doesn't have inbuilt analog support on the GPIOs, which we'll see in a coming video. So guys, let's check it out. Let's get started. So guys, this is a connection that we are going to need to work out with MCP328 with Arduino. So over here you can see this is the Arduino board, and this one over here is the MCP328, and it uses the SPI port to interface with Arduino. So over here, this is nothing special, just simple connections from Arduino to MCP328. No any like discrete components or anything else is required. So this is like the VCC and ground of your MCP328, both connected to the Arduino VCC and ground, and the pin number 13, whatever on the Arduino, goes to the clock pin of your MCP328. For pin number of your MCP328, you can refer the datasheet. Okay. Then the DIN pin, there is nothing but the MOSI pin, goes to the MOSI pin of Arduino, that is the pin number 11. Then the D out pin, which is the meso pin, okay, that gets connected to the pin number 12 of Arduino, which is nothing but the meso pin of Arduino. Then the CS pin can be connected to any digital pin, but remember, whichever pin you are getting connected over here has to be there in the code. So for my setup, I have connected it to the pin number 10. And this side over here is nothing but the ground and VCC, along with some VREF and analog ground. So depending upon the analog signal, whatever you are providing from channel 0 to channel 7, you need to connect to the ground pin of analog ground. Over here in my setup, I have connected to the same supply, so I have connected to the common ground. Okay. And VREF takes the maximum voltage or voltage reference for the ADC. So I have connected it to the supply because I am going to supply the signal from channel 0 to channel 7 to like in between 0 to 5 volt, whichever is provided by the Arduino over here. So that again depends on the source of the analog signal, whatever you are using, accordingly you need to provide the VREF voltage. So let's make the connections quickly and we'll see how to interact with using the Arduino board.
So guys, this is the connections I have made, that I have connected the MCP328 to the Arduino by the SPI port, and I have connected one potentiometer to the channel 0 of MCP328 as soon earlier. So that's all with this. Let's get back to the IDE and we'll see how to interact with this MCP328 and we'll try to read out the channel 0. So I'll just try to vary the potentiometer over here, and that should vary the readings from the MCP328. So let's get back to the IDE and we'll start coding to interact with this.
So guys, this is the code we are going to use to interact with the MCP328 from Arduino. So over here you can see I have used the SPI.h library, that is actually you are going to use the hardware SPI functionalities available on the Arduino. So just need to include this, and over here I have defined the CS pin as pin number 10. Again, this may change if you are connected like CS pin on a different digital pin. Okay. Then this like serial port installation, there is nothing special. We just need to print out the data that we are logged from the MCP328. Then define the CS pin as output, as because the CS pin is nothing but a control signal, that is like output to the that is input to the MCP328. So we are pulling the CS pin high because the MCP3208 is low triggered. And over here, this initializes the space port. And it's simple, nothing but like a set clock divider, that is, we are dividing the space clock by 2. So this actually can try out with different speeds, and this actually worked out pretty good for me. So what it basically does is like, it configures the SPA port clock speed. Like if you are running a 16 Hz like Arduino, 16 MHz Arduino, then DIP2 does it like make this half, and your like SPA clock speed is now 8 MHz. So by default it is like DIP4, but you can configure to have a higher speed or lower speed depending upon whatever you want. Now there is nothing special over here. It reads the ADC and it takes one parameter, that is like with your channel you want to read, it takes from 0 to 7. Okay, now it's this is this function over here is defined over here. Okay. So this what it does is it reads that particular channel and it prints out the value with every 2 seconds. Now this is something important over here. In the read ADC function, what I have defined is like output that is to be returned by this read ADC function, the value or the samples read by the MCP3208. Now what it does is it takes the channel 4 or whatever value you have provided over here and it's 6 bits. So for this is like this code defined over here totally depends upon the data sheet. Okay, so whenever you open up your data sheet, you can see something like, go to page number 18. Now over here you can see whenever you are interacting MCP3208 with any microcontroller, you need to send 3 bytes of data. Okay, these are like 3 bytes, and in returns it will whenever you transfer first byte it returns you nothing, but with the second byte it returns you the MSB of the sample data it has read, then the third byte returns you the LSB. Okay, so first byte whatever you are going to transmit from Arduino takes 3 parameters, that is the start bit, that is 1, then the mode you want to like access the MCP3208, like it's single ended mode or differential mode, and the D2 value. And the second byte takes the D1 and D0 value, and all other bits are don't care, you can transmit 0. So the D0, D1, D2 value depends upon the channel you want to read. Okay, so over here you can see configuration bits for the MCP3208. So over here is the D20, D0, D1 value depends upon the channel you want to read, and that is defined over here. So if you want to read the channel 0, you need to send 000 like 1000 with extra 1 bit, that becomes 11000. Okay, so right now like that you can like find out different values. Let's get back to the code again, and over here I have made 6 bit shift for the data whatever you have transmitted over here, that is nothing but the channel number. So let's say I have given 4 or 2 anything, so it gets 6 bit shifted. Okay. Now to initiate the transmission between Arduino and the MCP3208, we are going to pull the CS pin or the control pin low because it is low triggered, and after the end of transition we are going to pull it high. So as I told earlier, we need to transfer like 3 bytes. So 1 byte goes over here and second third. So second returns of the MSB, third returns of the LSB. So over here from the data sheet you can see the last 3 bits of your first byte to be transferred determines the which channel you want to read and the mode you want to read the mode on, like it can be differential or it can be single ended. So first bit over here, one bit number 1 defines the start bit, second is the mode, that is we are using single ended mode, third is either 1 or 0. Like if you are reading from like say channel 0 to 3, it can be 1, it can be 0, and if you are reading from 4 to 7, it can be 1. Okay. So this if condition defines that. Now the channel bits, the next byte is the D0 and D1 value, that is the channel number shifted by 6 positions. Okay, Now, last is the don't care byte that you want to transfer. That is nothing but 00 we are transferring. So these two MSB and SB is now required to be combined to get the sample count from the ADC. Now we are going to, like, MSB is again, as the data returned from the MCP3208 is like 12 bits, we need to discard the upper 4 bits of your MSB. So over here the AND operations makes all 4 bits of upper 4 bits of your MSB 0. Now it has to be combined, the MSB and LSB. So this AND OR function over here combines the MSB with LSB and which is again sent to the written by the function. So let's run it, or let's put it into the Arduino. I'll see the value read by the Arduino using the MCP3208. So as I shown earlier, I have connected one potentiometer to like the breadboard, and it can be connected to any channel. Right now I'm using the channel number 4. Okay. So we'll change the potentiometer value and see if the value over here printed onto the serial port or serial terminal changes. Now let's try to change the potentiometer, and the value over here will change. Okay, now you can see when I try to move the knob of the potentiometer, the value is getting changed. Like this, you can like check out other channels also and connect the potentiometer or whatever sensor you want to interface it with. So if you this actually nothing but returns you the sample count. So if you want to like map into like something value you want to read, like let's say voltage or something, you can use the map function of your Arduino stock library. So that's all with this, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.
Hey guys, it's me once again, and hope you have liked my video. If so, just hit the thumbs up button. If you don't, there is a thumbs down button for you also. And don't forget to subscribe my channel for latest updates. Okay, see you next time with my new content. That's all, guys. Thank you. Thanks for watching.